Hayden Lewis, Razmafzar USA is going to show Khanjar and Separ. So he's a. I really like the way he does Khanjar and Separ. You can see years of MMA and boxing training and kickboxing. You see that. And that's what I always say. You see the difference. If you have only a fencing background, you will not quite be able to do the same moves as Hayden is doing with Khanjar and Separ. That's what I mean, dedication, power and move of the upper body, which lends itself the best for Khanjar and Separ fight. Look at this, the way Khanjar is used for downward cuts and thrusts, for sideways and for, you know, like vertically upwards. You see this, like uppercut, jabs, cross, and okay, additionally vertical strike to the head. I like the way he moves. The guard is closed. Sometimes the guard gets open, but I like it. And also the move he does. You see the natural movements of Hayden with Khanjar and Separ is much better than Shamshir and Separ. When you look at it with our people who come from fencing background, they do with Shamshir better, but then the Khanjar and Separ is not that good. That's the difference what I meant about the martial arts background, that they dovetail and transfer. They can transfer knowledge from one to the other. You see the way he moves with his upper body? That's where the power transfer comes. Hayden is a strong guy, and also he weighs quite, I mean, on a heavier side, which is with lots of muscle power, which I really enjoy. And like when I watch his moves, right, which means he can put lots of force behind his strikes. You see how the shield strikes are done, how Khanjar is done. Khanjar comes so naturally in his arm and his hand and together with the Separ. Make sure you just integrate a bit more shield punches, or sometimes just for gauging, right? You don't need always to shield punch. You can just stretch it a bit to gauge the distance, or push it gently away. Not always hard. Otherwise he keeps going away all the time. So that's what Hayden is doing at the moment, as you can see it here. Make sure that you bring variation, as I mentioned it to you. Sometimes, you know, you don't need to always go forward and back. When you step forward, it's right, you just can step left forward, then go to the side. You know, bringing in variation, make sure that you keep your opponent guessing. You can never tell what comes next. And that's important if you want to land your strikes. This is true for any martial arts, with or without weapons, including grappling range. So he's doing quite, yeah, that's a good job. Just keep going, be relaxed, and keep moving all the time, right? Don't stand still and keep moving, please, right? So that's what Hayden is doing at this moment. Here he is holding it in the other way around. Normally we don't hold Khanjar like that because you need powerful strike. The edge should be towards your elbow, not other way around. That's our colleagues do in Indonesian martial arts and Karambit. Remember, Karambit is not with armor or heavy canvas, so you can do that for further reach, but you don't need to trust the way we do with Khanjar. Especially downward strike, the tip should be towards you, so you can penetrate thicker layers of clothes and opening of the armor. So that's what I need to say about that. Please subscribe to our channel. And